Hey everyone, this is the Lego City Sailboat Rescue Set. It is a latecomer to the 2017 Coast Guard sub-theme of City. And in the United States at least, from what I've seen, this is a Target Stores exclusive. Now we don't frequently get sailboats from Lego, so in concept at least, this is a treat. You know, it's something significantly larger than the typical sailboard that they tend to give us, you know, windsurfing setups. This one does use a unitary hull, so it's actually able to float in the water, which is great. It is a motorboat style of hull with a very large transom, and it's got, looks like some planing strakes around it, but I'm okay with that. I'm definitely okay with that because they've actually done a decent job of trying to make it look like a sailing craft. And the only thing that's really wrong here for me is the sail, which is unfortunate. Well, the sail and the mast, the whole sailing assembly up here, because it's very small and it's also kind of just right in the middle of the whole thing. This sail itself is probably smaller than a small jibsail would be, just a foresail, something that would be up here, and then you should have a much larger sail and a much taller mast in the back. And that just unnecessarily restricts just how good this looks to me personally. It is a little bit plain just in its overall design. I mean, when you look at the stuff that they've done for the deck here, I guess this is okay, but I wish they had maybe increased the height of the cabin section just a little bit. There's some space inside, but you can't actually use it. It's not usable. I mean, you can take one of these off, but what are you gonna do there? I guess you could temporarily stow some gear down there, some extra sails. They don't give you any extra sails, but it's kind of what that's intended to be based on the size of this. I mean, relative to the size of the figure, you would just expect to have more of an actual interior on a boat of this size. You are able to bring the sail around from one side to the other, but you're not able to completely change the points of sail without taking some stuff apart, putting it back together, because you're always going to be on this side of the mast and the boom until you know, redo things. This is also a vinyl piece that is printed only on one side, so the color is stronger on this side than here. Not that big of a deal. Again, I like this, the ability to bend the whole thing down. Whoops, he says, and then he breaks it off completely. Let's try that again. To bend the whole thing down, I'm actually just gonna rotate the boom off to the side. There we go. So you can use that for storage, you know, for travel, you know, get it down into a more manageable position, take the sail off if you want to, but you can also use this to represent a broken mast, you know, probably an aluminum one that just buckled right down there at the base. And, you know, that's good for getting the guy into trouble so that he needs help from the Coast Guard. And he's got his tiller here, so rudder's off the back. You actually can rotate that from a distance. That's cool. I think you could potentially even extend this down a little bit, move some parts around, and make it actually work as a working rudder. It's actually possible to get this thing, I believe, to sail if you have calm water and a gentle breeze. But just a very simple looking thing to me. The Coast Guard boat is also pretty simple and plain, but I'm having trouble deciding whether I appreciate that in it or dislike it. It's probably somewhere in between the two. It has some nice lines to it, actually. I like that single large windscreen piece, just how raked back it is in the front. It makes it look sleek. It also gives it a nice covered space for the single operator inside. So that's good. But in some ways, it also just has a little bit of a feeling of the era of Lego when they were, it's probably like late 90s to very early 2000s, when they were making some sets that had just really large pieces, you know, just a minimum number of them. So some simplicity there. I don't know if it's classic or if it's just plain. I do like the builds of the outboard motors, even though they are a little bit blocky. Just having those couple of hollow studs exposed on the back makes them look like they've got some exhaust ports back there. These will actually spin up, and this is another hull that will actually float in the water. So both of the boats included in this set will float, and that's really good. And you can actually move this back and forth in the water, and the propellers will actually turn a little bit on their own. You can also bring these up if you're gonna put it onto a trailer or something. You know, obviously no trailer is included with this set. Only one Coast Guard figure is included here. I really would have liked to see a second one to really help out with rescue, so you can have one person in there, you know, who's controlling the thing with somebody else then outside to make direct contact with someone that they're trying to save. The cockpit area only has a steering wheel in it, and that's it. Kind of a simulated section that you might expect to have a console on it. So at least, you know, you get to use your imagination a little bit there. That's helpful. It's kind of rounded behind this guy. It's a little bit different shape. Doesn't quite go with the rest of the shape, but I like seeing something different there rather than just leaving it completely square. You're not able to actually put a figure in there just standing inside the place though. Has a couple of clips for accessories. So here is just a regular, you know, walkie-talkie radio. Here's a megaphone, and then they've got all the searchlights. So little ones off to the sides can be turned from side to side, and they've got the big ones, more like a proper floodlight up here at the front. Lastly, there's a little bit of a terrain build. So the idea here is that the sailboat may run aground into these rocks, into this rocky outcropping here, which has a little bit of foliage coming off of it. And the way they did it is kind of clever. I like how there's that space in between, which shows you that there's water around, but actually gives you some watery space to accidentally pilot your boat right up into, and then it kind of gets wedged in there. That kind of makes sense. And then the person who's on the boat over here can just walk off and just sit on top of one of these rocky outcroppings and wait for help while his boat just gets beat up on the rocks. So here are the two figures up close, the sailor on the left and the Coast Guard officer, the lone one on the right. I will take off those PFTs or life jackets, whichever they're supposed to be. But both of these have nice prints. I especially like the one on the left, the regular sailor. It's just a very generic thing that can be used in all sorts of different situations. The Coast Guard one is also kind of casual, you know, it's not too much of a fancy uniform there. So I could see that being used in just regular city scenarios as well, if you just kind of ignore the logo right there. Nicest thing here is that you actually get at least one alternate face between these two. So when this guy is in trouble, he can look the part. Where he's really scared, he doesn't know if he's gonna lose his boat completely, he doesn't know if the tide is coming in, if the seas are coming up. And, you know, he's sitting on the rocks, still has his coffee mug with him, but he's very scared. So this is appropriate for that. Of course, he could also just be scared of this shark. This is a very sharky shark. Maybe it could even be a snarky shark. I don't know which of those would be more scary or more disturbing. I think a snarky shark may be more disturbing because, you know, in addition to the wit that'll be pretty piercing, he can still bite you, he can still eat you. So it kind of hits you in two ways. You know, the price to part ratio in this set looks pretty bad, but you have to consider that a lot of the material included in the set is wrapped up in two fairly large boat hulls, especially this one. So I actually think that for the volume of stuff that you get here and for the play value that you get, the price is pretty good and the value is in a pretty ideal range, or pretty normal range. I personally would have liked to see at least one more minifigure included with this, and it could have been on either side. I mean, this is a pretty big boat for just one guy to be sailing alone. You could have had one more citizen here, or you could have brought in a second Coast Guard, you know, person to help out with the rescue either. But overall, yeah, I think the value is pretty good. The fact that both boats will actually float is a big major boon to play. I just think that the designs of both of these boats are lacking. Had I designed this set, had I been tasked with designing this set, I think I would have gone with smaller boats for both of these. Similar styles, but smaller, but then I would have done them with non-floating hulls. So that actually would have taken away some play value in favor of better detail and a little bit more realism, especially for the sailboat. And that's it for my thoughts on this sailboat rescue set. I'm glad this thing finally showed up for sale someplace where I can buy it. And I'm gonna continue working on more videos. So as always, I'll be talking to you again soon. Thanks for watching.